Colin's birthday app.
Birthday boy. 29.
29, yeah.
You're a big boy now.
You know what that means?
What?
Birthday beats.
No! No! Happy birthday!
I'm only on 18. Okay. Come on, we got long.
No happy, swinging him.
Birthday beats. Believe now, you do yours.
No.
Literally, come on. Come on, come on, 29 punches. Come on, take it, just take it. Punch him, go on, fucking hit him, get him, live. 3, 4, 5, 6. Harder than that. Actually, harder though. Well, harder. Birthday beats, get him.
Class. I'm fucking beat up with my mum and dad's. How is everyone anyway? Well, we haven't spoke for a while.
Yeah.
It's been like a week.
Yeah, you've been in Germany. I was meant to go to Germany.
Yeah, I was gutted. I
couldn't go to due to unseen circumstances. I'm not allowed to leave the country. Mm. It's a legal thing, but
yeah. That's why you're incognito. Yeah. You disguise.
Hence me disguise, yeah. Of a Mexican drug lord.
Oh, I've actually got a dead left arm.
Ha, you're welcome.
I know, I did put a little bit of...
Yeah, there was a bit of a power. I feel like that was from last week's episode.
A little bit of venom in them.
He's been saving it up.
There's a little bit of venom in them shots, I'll be honest with you.
Yeah.
Caught him with one of you, go back in slow-mo, I catch him with one straight through the middle. Yeah, man, I was Germany for Jay Allen's stag.
Yeah, it was so good. It was nice because there was not that many England fans there. And when there was, they were all where the England game was. All the dickheads were, not in Munich.
Oh, good.
We just, all the Scottish, we hung around with them. They were fucking class.
Oh, nice.
Seen so many Scottish willies. Every time they're just raising the kilts like that.
Oh, did they have kilts on?
Yeah, yeah. They fucking went for it.
So funny that on the opening day, though, because, Scottish people are, notoriously patriotic.
Mm.
And then in there in the thousands, 5-1 was it?
Yeah, yeah.
Beat 5-1. Yeah. And it must be so shit to be a Scotland fan, man.
I know.
I'm an England fan, by the way.
No. We saw loads of Albanians. The Albanian fans are fun. We were drinking with them. One of them started a fight with a door and just started punching this door in. And then all the police came and they were like, we need the statement and that from me. And I was like, ich bin not a snitch. Yeah.
We have Mays if I can get talk. Albanians just seem, even the name is scary.
Mm.
If someone went, come on, with these gang of Albanians, well, is this the start of Taken? I'm not going to fucking, no way, no thank you.
Well, that was a lot of fun, man, because I thought it would be a bit mad, someone taking their dad on their stag do. Because I just didn't know if it'd be totally different energy.
Jay Allen's.
James Allen's dad come with us, and he ended up going home early because he had too much beef.
Not too much beer. Yeah, too much beef.
He had a double Big Mac and two double cheeseburgers, fries and a milkshake.
Oh, you didn't do that, did you? Did you eat any German cuisine?
Yeah, we got a German sausage and that.
Okay, bratwurst, that's enough. Go on.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
I made it with the waiter in there because he wouldn't split the bill six ways. So he was like, you need to pay for it all together. And we were like, no, we need to split it. He's like, I have no time.
What?
Yeah, yeah.
They don't do that in Germany?
No, he was so angry with us. Because we all had cards as well. They only most of them only take cash. They're just obsessed with cash there.
In Germany?
Yeah.
That's but
they were just, yeah. They were a little bit moody with English ones.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. And they couldn't really guess where I was from. I don't know if they thought I was a Turk German.
Were they quite rude?
Majority were lovely. Mm. We went to this Bayern Munich bar, and the guy behind the bar who worked there, he was an old ultra. Like, he was, like, one of the fucking head cases. Like, he had a Mohican, and he must have been, like, late 70s. But he was cool as fuck. But, yeah, it was that good. It was nice. Went to wear strippers. That was fun.
Oh, nice.
It got, like, one... Got, like,
Jay, a, Jay, was Jay's dad there with him?
No, that was the day... That was when he went home with Beef.
What about Lani's dad? Was she that was... Was James's girlfriend's dad in the strip club with you?
Yeah, he came with us.
Oh, wow, yeah.
Yeah, he had a great time.
How was James? Was it a lot of like David Brent, like, oh, like loosening his collar and stuff?
So we done, we gave him like a checklist to do.
I can't speak with this on, sorry.
We gave him like a checklist to do.
Yeah.
And like all like stag energy shit.
Yeah, what was the checklist?
One of them was like he had to get a German kiss. So like two Germans had to kiss the sides of his cheeks. But he didn't get that one though.
Yeah, that's hard. Oh, you can't pull that one off anymore, man. Unless you got Riz.
To be fair, we found two German girls who we went to like the fan park and we were like chatting to them. And then they were like, oh, why are you? And I was like, oh, it's a stag. Do we need to get a German kiss? So can you kiss both cheek? And they looked at Jay because he had like a mankini on. Crop top. And they went, nine.
Nine.
One of them was like, Jay's got the biggest bush I've ever seen, like pubes. Like never trims them.
You gotta trim, James.
Why did you see his pubes?
Because he sleeps completely naked and walked around the hotel with his willy out.
And he must be hanging some meat then.
I couldn't see it. It was like you know the scene from The Hangover with Mr. Chawaz, like,
oh
his
my god.
So one of the tasks was for him to trim his pubes, but I lit them on fire, and he just didn't go off like a good 3 seconds.
You lit his pubes on fire?
Yeah. Whilst they were attached to him?
They were attached to him, yeah. But it was like, you know, like Looney Tunes when they like dynamite. And it was like, it just sizzled.
Was he in the same room as you?
We, me and him shared the room together.
Oh, the room was a stank.
Yeah.
It smelled burning hair, burning pubes.
And then we were out when we done it. Oh, okay. We were like out in public.
That's much better.
Why is James Allen here to Steve all of a sudden? Never do anything like that.
Yeah. But we had a fucking great time, man. It was so good. That's what I'm saying. I think I can't drink Guinness anymore because I think Guinness is what really fucks me up.
Yeah, it's been saying
just
this.
On lager there. I went to Hitler's place for you.
Yeah, how was that?
Beer hall. Yeah, it was class.
Were there any suspect characters there where you were like, they're probably here for the wrong reasons?
Yeah,
really?
Nah, but I didn't get like a pint in that night because it was so busy because it was like pure tourist. Yeah, I just walked in. But yeah,
quick salute.
Yeah.
Hello.
Did you do any beer bikes and anything like that? Or?
They didn't have them on?
Nah.
Yeah, they didn't have a lot of things on while the Euros was on.
So funny, it was. I seen a little bit of Kyle Legacy's story, and he's walking down the street smoking a joke, video of himself going, "Yes, baby, legal weed in Germany." And you can just see like everyone behind him, and his dad's going, "What are you doing, lads?" Fucking turning in.
So he purposely went in a hostel because one of the reviews was like he got sucked off in a shower. Like some lad said, he got sucked off.
It was like a 2-star. It was like a 1-star review.
It was a proper like low star hotel, but it was like a hostel.
Oh,
but it was sound like we went there a few times, and then
Kyle thought he was gonna get laid in this hostel.
Mate, the receptionist went to him when he was checking out. Was like, "How did you find your stay?" And he went, "I didn't get laid, but it was sick." Defo, come on back.
He's a fucking
He fucking done another cameo.
Why we would have
no.
Yeah. He was going, "Ring a ring ding, it is the king." He was like, "Happy Father's Day to the father coming from the daddy."
What are you doing? Keep your money.
I know. You think you made about £8 off it?
Stayed on the beer, baby.
Stayed on the beer.
Oh my god.
Well, no, a lot of fun. A lot of drinking.
What would you do for your stag?
My stag? I don't know. I always like fucking change like what I'd want to do. Because like going abroad, it's so expensive.
Do you choose your own stag?
I think so. I think you just choose where you want to go and then...
Yeah, they'll plan.
I'd never do that thing of like, we're going to dress you up as a baby and then burn your pubes. I'd be like, I know, it's not happening. Yeah. It's not happening.
The weirdest one is when people dress up as like nonces. Like loads of people dress up as Jimmy Savile. Like they used to come in the club dressed as Jimmy Savile and be like, take it off.
I'm the,
why are you dressed as a nonce? Like, it's so weird. Why are you dressed as a nonce? Are you stag do?
Dumb, innit? It
doesn't
dumb.
Make any sense.
Yeah, it's that stuff. I mean, I don't mind that. I get that. I get like wearing a silly costume. Yeah. But it's like, I mean, I wouldn't. I'd say no immediately.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like Jay was a really good sport with it all. Like it was just like for like half a day of like doing it, because the stuff, it wasn't really that like one of the like some of the funny ones where like we were watching.
Oh, we had to celebrate a corner.
Like Denmark, yeah, and he had to celebrate a corner. Like in front of all Denmark fans, and like people were just like buzzing off it because it was just this English guy in a mankini. Yeah, like it wasn't like fucking extreme. Like when Paul Smith's won, he literally got half of his face shaved off.
Yeah.
So like he had beard like from that way there. Like, and he got fake tanned. Yeah. He had like full Lonsdale on, size 14 Lonsdale slip ons, and he had to go and do crowd work to a table of Germans. Like shit like
oh
that.
Oh my god.
But yeah.
Fuck that.
Like stag energy can get really out of hand.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I can imagine.
Do you know what I mean?
Not my scene. I think mine would be really boring, man.
Yeah. And you're local.
I honestly think mine would be like a meal and yeah, maybe a little drink and a boogie. Like I probably wouldn't go abroad for it.
I don't know. I think I would. I think I'd go somewhere cheap.
I'd either go quiet one or to Thailand and have like a fucking like go disgusting and just lady boy central.
Yeah,
have one last gay fucking lollop about Thailand just before I wed my wife.
Bangkok,
oh my god, funny story, man. I remember my cousin. I have to say his name because it's in the story. So my cousin Matty, I just at a family party went, got chatting, and Thailand came up, and he went, oh, my mates just came back from Thailand, and he went, actually watch this video, and it's his mate in Thailand. So it wasn't him, sorry, it was his mate in Thailand in bed with a prostitute videoing himself, and he's going, she can't understand a word he's saying, right? And he's going to this poor girl, say Matty Will, say I love Matty Willow now. she's going, I love my Willow. It was so violent and like off-putting, and you're laughing, but you're going, this is horrible. And because she can't understand the Scouse, he's sliding in words she can't understand. So he's going, say I love Matty Willow, say it right now.
Do you remember that kid? He went fucking viral on like Snapchat. And like his videos were just going all over Twitter and that, and he was away in Thailand just shagging like ladyboys, like wearing no protection or anything. And he's just oh, yeah. Do you remember? You mentioned
gangster, fucking gangster.
Yeah. But he was just like,
oh, is he the one who sent the voice notes? And he's like, oh, you question it at first, you know, and then, yeah. And then you have a go and you fall in love with them, bro.
Bro. Yes, bro.
Or Thailand twice a year, bro.
I don't know, Thailand be funny for a stag.
Apparently, there's some really, really seedy places in Thailand where you can, like a lot of paedophiles go over to Thailand stuff, apparently.
Yeah, because there's, like, young, like, do you see the one with
kids,
the...
Yeah, you can, yeah.
There was, like, I seen a picture of one where it was, like, this, like, young lad. And then
I thought you were just going to go, and he's like that. He's like, I thought you were going
to
do
no. So he's like lying next to like a proper old guy, like an old white guy. He's like, just got a new iPhone.
Yeah. There used to be, man, round by ours, there was a little tiny patch of grass. We play football. I'm talking 12, 11 here. And there was a house facing, and this fella was known, he'd go to Thailand, I mean, four times a year. This fella, white fella, lived on his own. And as kids, not proud of it, but as kids you go nonce house. That's the nonce
yeah,
in our
area. Yeah.
And we'd egg his house, right? And by the way, looking back, he probably was a fucking paedophile.
Yeah,
this fella.
You can tell.
No exaggeration. I remember once we're playing footy, dead sunny day, and it was like the best place to grow up, to be honest. It was mad, but it was all the kids were out all the time. We're playing footy, and no word of a lie. And it was one of the younger kids saying, like, oh my god, look in his window. And we've looked up the window, mate. It sounds like I'm exaggerating. There was a camera on a fucking tripod, mate, in his upstairs window. So after that, his house was free game. Yeah. Free game. No one was asked to whatever he wants to his fucking house.
What are you filming though?
We're just playing footy. We're just playing footy in there.
Well, how's that sexy?
What fucking? I mean, I don't know how their mind works, but I imagine that's enough to get them at least semi calm. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
What's like the worst?
It's probably the thrill of like filming.
Have you had the wank over something non-sexual?
What do you mean?
Well, because like that's non-sexual, isn't it? Like just playing footy.
But it's clearly doing something for him if he's filming kids.
I know, but have you had a wank over something? Like a girl, like say like you're watching like a film.
Like origami? No, I've never wanked over origami. You know?
I've wanked over a girl having a smoke.
What?
Smoking?
Yeah, yeah.
You found it that erotic?
During COVID. It was like a live chat room and she was just on this chair with like a boobs all having a cig.
Was it like a chesty cough? Is that what you got you going?
Chicks love that romantic crap.
She was just out
were
there
you
like
that starved of
send me money.
Were you that starved of female attention in lockdown? You were going on like webcam sites.
It was when I was like doing crypto and that. So like the crypto coin I was in, they were like the first crypto casino,
right?
And it's fucking this is me. Right, so one of my mates who I was doing crypto with, he made like 12 grand from like another coin. So he was like, we were both in this other coin together, the casino one. And they were like, right, we've got major news dropping. They were like, get ready for this. And then my mate was like, because usually when like big news happens, the chart just goes up because everyone gets excited. So my mate was like, right, I'm going to put this 12 grand in it. So he put his 12 grand in it. And we're all in this group chat. Like it was on Telegram. Have you been on Telegram? You can have like 10,000 people in a chat. Yeah. It's like a massive WhatsApp. So we're all in this Telegram chat. And there's a casino coin. Like, right, the news is dropping. My mate put 12 grand in. He just put all that money in. And then they done like a video call of the news. And it was just like this stripper. And she was just like twerking, just clapping her bum cheeks. And then like, when she clapped her bum cheeks, the chart just halved. People just started cashing out. And I went to me, I was like, when she clapped her bum cheeks, it was like when Thanos, So my mate lost all his money. And I was like, you know what? I'm just going to check out this thing, what they've done. So it was just like strippers on webcam and you can pay them crypto to just do stuff.
Yeah.
So I was just like, oh, I'll just watch this. And then I found like this girl and she was just smoking and I was like, oh, I'll just send her like 3 quid.
You send her money?
Yeah, I was like, smoke another one.
Smoke another one. Men really will do the weirdest shit.
Sparking at the biff to there for us.
Yeah, but it was COVID, wasn't it?
That's heavy though.
COVID doesn't count. Them 3 years, whatever happened in COVID is it's.
I'm playing.
Was it 3 years?
How long was it? Yeah, for Carl was just there. Carl was in a fucking Cam Gael coma. Just paying these girls all his tour money. He's going, yeah, sparking in the best. One of the Marlboro girls, you fucking slag.
You were going to join him with him stories like that. And
I was playing Red Dead Redemption. He's like fucking chatting to Albanian sex slaves.
Now Lambert Butler.
Yeah.
Two at the same time.
Fucking hell, that's hilarious. That can
paying in crypto as well.
Yeah,
that's all I did. In
terrible times on crypto.
That's all I did in lockdown. Oh, where's the Camden House?
Oh, it was over there.
Where's the Camden House? That's all I did. Played Red Dead Redemption.
I've started playing it now.
You've just started?
First time up because Elden Ring's out tomorrow.
We won't see Callum for it. It's the best.
It's
probably my favourite video game
I'm up to the where they go the island from the boat.
Okay, Burma. Oh, yeah. No, not in Burma. Yeah, but it's the little island. It's meant to be a cube, isn't it?
Fucking sleep bit me.
It's the best game ever. Because you find yourself like you'll be halfway through the game, and then you'll just go, you know what, fuck it, I'm just gonna go to like the I'm just gonna go camp, just hunt and shit.
I went camping on it.
Lad, it spends hours fishing.
Yeah,
spends hours fishing.
Like, I don't want to come down instead of going Wales.
Just go to Wales. But like, honestly, God, I got that amazed in Red Dead Redemption 2. I'd farm me, I'd trot. I'm just like, do you know the way you usually sprint to like your nearest mission?
Yeah, passing people, howdy partner.
And I'm saying it, when I was on the What's Happening podcast, I was like, I got so into character. I was like walking into saloons and buying whiskey. What am I actually doing? And then do you know the bit in Red Dead when like you've got to bathe yourself?
Did you get a wank?
they don't do anything to you.
They do.
So in
you have to give them crypto.
So in GTA and stuff like that, you can shag prostitutes in your car. And on Red Dead, what they do is you've got, when you go to a saloon, you get a bath.
Yeah.
you'll wash one arm and then you'll wash the other arm and then you'll hear like a knock on the door and it'll be some like little hoe, some little Western hoe. And she'll be like, hey there, darling, need some help? And you can go like, yeah. And you come in and they wash you.
Yeah.
Which, but I'd find myself being like, no, thank you, ma'am.
You're a faithful boy.
Yeah, no, I was like,
faithful
was like,
cowboy.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I was
this
like,
is the return of the faithful cowboy.
I like to them. You keep that money, man, for some gig or whatever.
I love it.
Yeah. Oh, I love that.
Oh, I'm really enjoying it. Yeah. I've seen a video of this guy going, you wouldn't believe what you could do on Red Dead. And he literally fucking tied up a horse's legs.
No.
And like strung it up.
You can't do that.
This kid done it.
You can't tie
was
a horse's
PC?
Legs.
Maybe. There's yeah, like mods like and a shit mod, yeah. And then someone was like, yeah, because why would we want to do that?
Yeah.
But you do.
Fucking psychopath.
The first time I played it through, I was like, good. You know what I mean? When you make the right to like help people out. And then second playthrough, you're like, right, I'm just going to be the worst cunt the West has ever known.
Yeah.
And it's even think about it now, it makes me want to play it again.
Yeah, I'm good cowboy at the minute. I'm doing really nice things.
So good,
I used to tie people up and then feed them to the crocodiles.
Oh,
Can you do that?
Yeah.
You can literally tie people, put them on train tracks and wait there like a... You literally can. Do you know what else blew me mind? It was on Netflix the other day. I've started up Netflix. And if you've seen it, it came up GTA San Andreas.
And
then there was a barcode that was like, redeem this free game with your subscription. And I was like, what? So I've redeemed did the QR code. And now I've just got GTA San Andreas on my phone.
It's got Football Manager as well.
Has he?
It's got loads of games.
It's got Football Manager, yeah.
Yeah, I've got it on my phone. Yeah. There's loads of games.
Oh, I didn't know what I had Football Manager.
San Andreas, Football Manager. There's fucking loads.
That changes things now.
Yeah.
He's might near from me for a little bit now.
Yeah.
If I can get Football Manager on my phone.
I had a fight with the KKK on Red Dead.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
They were having like a meeting. Yeah. And I just had a Molotov and just went, bing, kill Kobe. And then I end up looting one of them, and like one of the messages they had, like I read like one of the KKK like meeting messages, and it was like, we're meeting up to like bring someone into the KKK or whatever. And then it was like another thing was like, change costume, really flammable. I was like, yeah, you got burnt.
Fucking great, man. I've been playing GTA San Andreas.
Oh, that's such a
good for the last couple of days.
It's mad how bad the graphics are.
Unbelievable. Yeah, when you were a kid, it was like mind change, you know, mind blowing. But it's so good. Like, I've literally been going to gym and stuff like that. GTA San Andreas, but I'm sitting there going. But getting me virtual character fit and healthy.
So funny.
I'm sitting there, skint and fat as fuck, right? Not doing anything to improve my own situation. Not looking for jobs, not going to gym, not running. But CJ from San Andreas, I've maxed out his muscle and I've got the money cheat. He's flying, I'm doing terribly. Virtually, I'm killing it.
I love San Andreas.
So good.
Then you can't wait for the new one to come out.
Oh, GTA 6.
It's going to be a lot. Well,
when's that? Is that 2025 or 26?
Next year, yeah.
Do you know what? I don't think we ever included it. Because we did first, I can't speak with this bastard, but it looks so cool with it. when we did the first three episodes a good time and we didn't release them.
We were speaking
about GTA, but it was one of the first times I set up a clip, so I went, oh, I really want to watch the new trailer for GTA 6, can we watch it? And then the link that Liv pressed play, it was just going to be a black woman getting ran over in real life, and I was going to go, the graphics are amazing. The graphics are great. So yeah, that's all I've been doing while you've been in another country where all your pals have been sitting there shooting up ballers.
Liv got her back sorted a bit today.
Yeah, no.
Her back fixed. Ladies, she's back in commission.
Ready for it to be blown out again.
And then my mum went to her, you look really straight. Liv was
never
feeling.
Felt so offended. Yeah.
Take me back.
Do you know what you did? And I can't say nothing really, but you did have kind of Mr. Burns posture. She kept looking like she was about to go, excellent.
Yeah. Just resting drinks on her back and that.
The hunchback of it's good. I don't know, so it's a bit
we'll get it, we'll workshop it. Going out tonight though, aren't we?
Yeah,
it's gonna be fun.
Birthday boy.
Yeah, we'll have a little beer tonight. Yeah.
Teddy's later.
Oh no, every time I'm in Teddy's, I for 20 minutes, I'm okay. And then I go, what am I doing here?
Yeah.
I hate it, man.
I love it.
I seen Nightingale put a gig on there not long ago.
It
looks good, doesn't it?
Really cool.
I would have never thought about a gig on in Teddy's, but it's low ceiling.
Yeah.
You know,
look quite sick.
Yeah, it looked good, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I was actually out with, you know, the girl from Danny Max, the one whose name's a tree, but I didn't remember her name, so I kept calling her Laquisha.
Laquisha.
Like the second setting. Yeah, ended up in Beer Engine with her until 6.
Oh,
I know.
If you end up in Beer Engine, it's gone too far.
Yeah, I know, man. Literally, I was like...
oh, maybe most of the times I've been in them boots, just wired.
Yeah.
Just like, we're getting hot wings and that, and you're like, oh, get me out of here. 5 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, podcast bad time in there, innit? Yeah. Just stuck in there. There was a night out me and you had, though.
Yeah.
When we come out of it and it was light.
Oh, that was minging.
Hearing birds after a night out.
Laughing at you on your way home. Oh, yeah.
There's a gig in a Baltic market on the 18th, couple of days ago, mm-hmm. but yesterday before, and a lad who I know from round by ours, came to the gig, and just as the gig starting up, I bumped into him in a toilet, and he went to me, you couldn't have one of them before you go on stage, could you? And I went,
oh, like a dare.
Almost like I was like, you tested me?
Do you know who I am?
You see what I look like?
I had one on the way, yeah?
And I went, go on, I'll have one. And I was opening. Mm. And it was sounds. I felt like Robin Williams. No, to be fair, I've done a
20-minute set in 5.
I've done it before, you know, but it's... But only when, and I'm not just to be like, look, I mean, yeah, I may have a problem. But it's also when, like, I'm flagging. And I feel, like, gouged and I don't want to be there. Stuff like that. And I was like, my depression has subsided all of a sudden. When I staged the belter. So one of the fucking... open mic has jumped on me punchline, the prick.
Oh, do you hear about that?
No, what?
He's not a bad guy. He's not a bad guy.
He's fucking moody, though.
Oh, no, he's not a bad guy, though. But I will preface. So what happened was, and he was just enjoying the show.
Enjoy it quieter, then.
I know. I do a joke about Salem Witch Trials, and I keep going, burn her, burn her.
I love that bit.
And it's working really well. And so anyway, you meant, I'm setting up a callback, right? Mm. And so you forget about it, and then I'm starting to do a joke about how I'm a jealous person in relationships, and then I went, he's like a guy who does comedy, and he just goes, burn her. So I couldn't even hide it. I just looked at him and went, you've just jumped right on my punchline there, Norbert. And luckily there was like something else I could have said that worked for it. And he came up after, and I was like hoping he'd apologize to me, and he never. And I went, don't do that again. And he was like, what? And I felt like a bit of a cunt in hindsight. When I came back, I thought maybe it was a bit OCT there, but I was like,
well, no,
just don't.
It's you can't do that.
To be fair to him, he was
especially
like,
someone who's starting comedy as well. Like, if he's watching it.
Shut up. But to be fair to him, he didn't know that was the punchline, but I was like, just don't speak. People are on stage if you do comedy, man.
Hush, hush. Shine, shine. Hush, hush.
Let me be funny. Yeah, it was alright though. It was nice. Little Baltic market gig. You know what? The only thing with that gig is it's lovely. Alex Murray puts a boss gig on, but it's such a big space.
Yeah.
So it's like doing a gig in a Costco.
Yeah.
So the vibration's mad and that, but I don't know. To be fair, I've did that a few times and I've always enjoyed it.
Yeah, I've done it once. It was nice.
I've always really enjoyed it. And they have the your name behind them, massive letters.
Yeah,
that's the only time that's ever happened for me.
Now he's cool. Like, he got us a free drink last night, which was nice of him.
Where?
In the Baltic.
Oh, did you go to Baltic last night?
I had to go for a beer. No,
what do you mean you had to?
To not get a hangover. Do you know when you're just trying to like level out from, like, you know, if you've been drinking for so long and then you have like, if you don't drink for a while, like if you don't drink for the next day, then you just fucking crash and you're hungover.
No.
Speaking like an alcoholic there.
Is that why I just making excuses?
No, it's not like what kills you. It's not like hair of the dog. That's just an excuse that alcoholics make.
Do you know where hair of the dog comes from?
No.
Back in the day, like Roman times and that, when someone got bit by a dog and they got rabies, he thought the way to cure it was to pull a hair off the dog's tail and you burn it and then you put it in like a liquid or something and drink it, and then it would like cure them from the rabies.
And, that's, like, and it weird. Never worked. Yeah, it just never worked.
Everyone just kept dying from rabies. And then they started like killing dogs who were like the puppies of the dog and that. Like sacrifice them shit.
Yeah, do it.
It's cool. I've got loads of facts.
Oh yeah, fact of the day. Is that your fact of the day? You just doing the Looney Tunes theme tune.
No, it's not much of a day tune.
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is odd.
What's odd?
You.
Why am I odd?
Why is he odd?
I'm just getting that vibe off
you. It's probably because I got battered at the start of the podcast, so
got a concussion.
I feel a bit all over the place.
Look at it, because she's got a fucking straight back now.
Oh, no, yeah.
You seem like odd.
You're odd.
You seem odd.
Oh, is this what I'm like when I'm straight? I don't like this.
Yeah. What's this, Liv? Jimmy Savile tweenies.
There was an episode of the tweenies that they did where they made like a Jimmy Savile tweeny and got him to judge like a talent show, but one of the songs that's on it that Milo sings, I'm sure it was Milo,
sorry, one two
Jimmy Savile was basically on the tweenies. Like they've made made him his own costume.
Oh, as a tweenie.
He
wasn't around when the tweenies went on telly. Oh no, yeah, you're just thinking of Max.
No,
the old man who's on it with them. This is so hard to talk in this fucking glasses, man. But I want to join in with the glasses.
Join in with the gang. No. Oh, I think I remember that.
Jimmy Savile's ghost appearance.
Hello, all you teddy guys and girls out there. Oh yes. Welcome to the Tweenie Chart Countdown. Today, you're going to hear all the Tweenie's favourite songs. Ooh. And first on stage is Young Milo. Ooh. He's chosen this number as his favourite song because he likes to move and dance. Ooh. So, at number four in the Tweenie's
it's
chart.
It's just him doing a Jimmy Savile impression, yeah.
One thumb.
Is that Jimmy Savile, though?
I don't think it's him. No. But yeah, and the song's called One Finger, One Thumb.
I always hated that jig.
One finger, one thumb.
In my bum.
Yeah. I always hated that jig from the Tweenies. His voice was horrible.
Oh, did you like him?
Remember? Hated that fucking voice, man. I loved him. I mean, we talk. Oh, this is that smile and friends I've been going on about, lads. It's so I've been recommend. I'm recommending it now to every single person. If you like obscurest comedy or like absurd comedy, there's a new cartoon called Smiling Friends. It's like an Adult Swim show, and it's just a funny.
Adult Swim's the fucking best.
Yeah.
Do you watch Mr. Pickles?
No.
Little dog and that, and they just go and kill people.
Yeah. Apparently there's loads of Adult Swim stuff on Channel 4 now.
Yeah, well he took Eric Andre now, didn't he?
Fuck off, can you watch Eric Andre on? Oh,
on Channel 4, yeah.
Good thing we never saw him live, you know.
I know, it looks sick.
Did you watch it as well?
I've seen some of the clips. Yeah. The clips look so good.
Eric Andre live is like on my bucket list, definitely, man.
What is that it? He's done now.
No, but he...
That was the last tour.
I imagine he'll tour again.
No, I think that was like the last one.
Fuck off, really?
Yeah, because he's just going all over Europe and that.
Heavy down. Obviously, but he runs out like immediately. So when you're in the audience, I think I know a few comics who went to watch him in Manchester. Mm. And have you seen the start of the Eric Andre show? Do us a favor, just YouTube Eric Andre intro. Eric Andre show intro. So he goes on a show and he smashes his setup.
Yeah.
And then rebuilds it all again as he's dead tired.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Eric Andre Show!
Funniest shows ever.
It's the best. It does look like so much fun though, doesn't it? Just doing that.
Yeah. I love that one, lad, when he goes, bring that naked PA out here. Yeah, the naked thing, come on, just that smelling, you know.
Well, I'd love to smash it.
Mate, it's
like a rage
room. I love the way you put it back.
Yeah,
it's so funny, man. But it's so on his live shows. They'll set it out so he'll have like gallons of milk set up and like loads of shit, and he comes on stage. If you just Google Eric Andre live show intro, because he comes out and just soaks the audience in shit and like milk, just starts throwing milk all over the audience and that. Yeah, look. So here's the live opening. Oh, I would have loved to have seen this.
Wasn't it standing as well?
Yeah, most of it's standing. Yeah, like a concert.
Yeah.
But that's the vibe you want anyway.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Eric Andre Show Live!
Oh, maybe it's getting soaked. Wars of Guns. It looks the best time ever, doesn't it?
This is what we're gonna do with a live show.
Yeah, we're putting to the audience in that.
He's just gone into the crowd. He's just punching the crowd.
It's like Gigi Allen. Oh, Gigi Allen is.
Nah.
You know who Gigi Allen is?
All right, go quite live after that. Nice one.
But he is dry on their own.
Yes.
We're back.
Love a bit of Amy Winehouse, man.
We break. Beer. Amy Winehouse.
Apparently the Amy Winehouse film was crap, though.
Who played Amy Winehouse?
I don't know. Like a relatively new actress, but she was really good, apparently. Here we go.
Another one?
Yeah, please.
Another one.
No, she looks bad enough. It was... Her name was... This one. Yeah, but anyway, I watched it. She's meant to be really good as Amy, apparently, but
the actual film was shit.
Yeah, because so I watched
Melissa Abella.
Melissa Abella, yeah. Because I'm a little sad cunt, so I sit down and just watch film reviews and like film analysis, and it was some like a really annoying ginger kid. Again, you know the thing about film critics and people like. Me and Callum were talking about that. There's certain YouTube channels that are just dedicated to like. Giving comedians shit, like big comedians like Big Kreischer and Brendan Shaw and people like that. It's dedicated to just slating them.
Yeah.
But these men do not get up and make videos, like hour long videos every day about other comedians and people creating something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, like people actually writing jokes and all they're doing is just criticizing. But I watched this one guy and he was talking about the Amy Winehouse film and he was like, it was just very, very.
They make so much money from it, though, that's why.
But the woman who directed the Amy Winehouse movie, I can't remember her name, Amy something. Do you know Aaron Taylor Johnson, the actor, he was in Kick-Ass?
No.
You remember, he was in Godzilla and Kick-Ass and names, stuff like that. Aaron Taylor Johnson, I'll send you the picture so you can pop it up in the edit.
But I'll put up here.
Bam! Yeah, Aaron Taylor Johnson.
No.
So I recognise his face.
Yeah, yeah. So he played John Lennon in a movie called Nowhere Boy when he was freshly 18. Freshly 18.
I don't like the way you're saying fresh.
I know.
Carry
he sounds
there's a
fresh.
There's a record of the movie. This woman, boy. Amy, was like 42 when she met him, and they've had a kid together and they're married now.
That's hot.
Yeah.
That's
yeah,
sexy.
Yeah.
That is sexy.
Yeah, but it's disappointing, isn't it? Because the Amy Winehouse, I love her, man. My mum used to play Amy Winehouse in the car 24/7.
She's great.
Yeah.
She was.
Yeah.
27 Club.
27 Club. Yeah. She was in that as well. And apparently it's just really run of the mill. Like, you got to be so careful with biopics, man.
Who would you have play you?
In a biopic?
Mm-hmm.
Now? Barry Keoghan. Bug Eyes Irish, lad. I don't know. Chris Farley's dead. I don't know.
Morgan Freeman, that'll be for you, Liv.
Oh, yeah. I'd take that, yeah.
I love the
Dalai Lama.
Yeah. Because they're making a Beatles one.
Yeah, I saw that advertised.
They're making a Beatles biopic. But I know we've had this conversation before about like who deserves a movie, but I was thinking the other day, fucking like, again, just musicians that proper deserve Prince. Prince would be a brilliant one.
Didn't they do a movie?
No.
Wasn't he 27 Club as well?
No.
No, he...
Well dead. No, yeah, he was like 52 when he died.
Oh, yeah.
Prince. But before the break...
I have 2016.
Yeah.
Yeah. Before the break, we were talking about a man called Gigi Allen. Who didn't make the 27 Club, yeah. Google him for his live. No, Gigi Allen was a punk singer in like the... eighties.
Okay. Yeah.
In New York. This fella, mate, was the craziest fucking performer. So he'd throw shit at his audience members.
Like actual shit.
He'd shit in his hand.
Yeah.
on stage naked and throw it at the audience.
No.
Yeah, I'm not messing to you. There's footage of him on YouTube of just beating women up at his shows.
Yes, let's go.
Beating women up, right?
Let's go.
Please, right now. first, before we delve into Gigi Allen, let's just listen to some of his music, right?
Okay.
So Gigi Allen, there's one called I wanna fuck you in the ass, lick this shit out of you. He was or just Gigi Allen song titles. Just type in Gigi Allen, see what comes up.
Any of these?
Kill the police.
Yeah. Just click enter.
Don't talk to me. Is he still a boss?
Oh yeah. Watch this clip. This is him on a talk show. Go up. Sorry, Liv. Watch this.
Is he still a boss?
No, he's well dead.
To be a Frank Sinatra fan. Rock and roll is the fury from within you. Rock and roll is revenge. Rock and roll is your enemy. Crazy. And I'm your enemy. And what do you do with your
rock and roll terrorists?
I do whatever it takes. If somebody's in my way, I'll take them out. You know, they're my enemy. I don't look at them. They're not my friends.
Okay.
What's left at the end, that maybe I'll take them on as allies. Because they were
Nazi.
Strong enough to be.
Is he a Nazi? Okay,
he was a Nazi from a Nazi.
What do you do on stage?
This is why you like them so much.
I might grab a girl and force her to.
It's the Jerry Springer show. What?
Did you know that? You missed it, come on. See what he just said? What he does to girls?
For me, I've had sex on stage with men, women, and animals.
You missed it, but he says he'll force a girl to have sex with
him. In rock and roll, there can be no limits or no laws, because when you start drawing laws and limits, then you might as well not even call it rock and roll anymore.
Well,
you might
as well call it rock and roll.
Isn't it true that you're just going on stage?
No, that's your opinion. You're part of the society that I despise. You're part of the people that say we should listen to this, we should watch MTV, we should be forced.
Who's the girl he's next to? Some poor little soulmate.
They're keeping their kids, they're sheltering their kids, they're censoring their kids, telling their kids to stay away from what's really going on in the real world. Those are the very people who are getting raped and killed because they don't know how to handle tragedy.
By the way.
Jerry Springer, by the way.
When this is before he used to get like
hillbillies on, just knocking each other out.
Jerry Springer was the fucking best.
Yeah, I got to pause that for us. So yeah, Gigi Allen, man, was a fucking absolute animal, and he always said. He said, I'm going to kill myself on stage.
And did he do that?
No, he never. Oh. He overdosed on heroin. And but he was a fucking wild boy, mate. Gigi Allen. Yeah. His big thing was, sorry again to do this to you. Just concert footage. And you watch him batter people on stage. There's one where a woman walks on stage, mate. And he punches her like, she's a man.
I love how he's got best fights. Like he's got a full on montage, 6 minutes long.
Yeah. He run into the crowd just out. Watch.
Oh my god.
Naked. He's only got bills on. Fighting his audience.
Did he start a mosh pit or?
No, he's just going up for the fuck. He's throwing the mic to them.
Oh my god. Shit. We've got so many good ideas for our live show now.
Look, people are going over the welly in a month.
Wow. But they're fans of him.
Yeah.
And they just love that.
They know what's going to happen when they go to the show. Yeah, he's well dead. Pause that, sorry, Liv. So there's a really good documentary on YouTube called Gigi Allen and the Murder Junkies, and that was the name of his band.
That's a fucking great name.
Gigi Allen and the Murder Junkies, and it's narrated by this fella. And there was another band, if you remember, another Ramones.
Yeah,
that famous. Mm-hmm. Like everyone's got to share to the Ramones. Hey, ho, let's go. Mm-hmm. One of their band members, I think it was like Dee Ramone, had a falling out with the Ramones, and he went, right, I'm joining a new band. And he went, go ahead, I'll join the Murder Junkies. He lasted a day. Yeah. And he said after the gig lasted 5 minutes. We lasted one song. Each threw shit at someone. We got threw out immediately by the police. So they're in a van in New York.
I love that.
They're in a van in New York in like the late 70s, going through by like Times Square. And he goes, Dee Ramone knew it was time to leave the band when Gigi Allen opened the van door and just started hailing glass bottles of prostitutes.
Shit!
To the point where someone from the Ramones went, nah, yous are horrible.
Oh, my God.
See you later. Yeah, fucking animals, remember? Gigi Allen, mate.
So was he massive, though? Or was
no,
he just
he was
like...
quite underground. He was dead underground and that, but after he died, people were like, did anyone see this cunt?
So was his music actually good?
For some,
or
so,
was he just, was he like the show, no, him no, and himself? Was yeah, he was yeah, like yeah, people yeah. come to watch him?
I mean, I think his music's garbage, but yeah. some like people who actually like punk go like, yeah, he was one of the best.
Oh shit.
But he was so destructive. He just couldn't, he was so like, I'm punk. Like, yeah. You know, Johnny Rotten, he was the lead singer of the Sex Pistols.
Yeah.
Not long ago, someone saw him with a Trump shirt on, Make America Great shirt again. And it's like, that's what a punk does, you know? A punk goes against society. Like, so he'll be like, oh, what are you doing? He's like, yeah, he's been a punk for fucking, he was the lead singer of the Sex Pistols. Of course. Yeah. Like, he's wearing that to annoy people and to whine his
style. So the original hipsters.
Yeah, but yeah, they were wild, man. They were, that geez, was crazy. So he always said, I'm going to shoot myself on stage. That's how I'm going to die. And he never got to do he absolutely would have. He absolutely would have. He never got to do that. But when he did die, they left his body how they found it, covered in shit. You know, because when you die, you shit yourself. So they left him how his body in a coffin, open coffin. And they put like a fucking crack pipe in there with him, or a needle, and a bottle of Jack Daniels.
It goes
to his brother, right?
Sounds like a great wake.
It goes to his brother in the documentary, you know, when it's like talking heads and they're just talking about them, and he's just got a Hitler mustache and you're like, fucking hell. And he was the drummer for the band. Yeah, nuts, man. GGL.
That's hilarious.
Was the boy.
That's a crazy funeral, that.
Yeah.
How do you want your funeral to be?
Really sad.
Do you?
I want everyone to be like, oh, he was the boy.
Nah, I want to get gonged off me.
Got gonged off.
Yeah. I honestly don't care. I'll be dead.
I want gong music on. I'm a loser baby from the Frog and Bucket.
Yeah.
So, and then I want three cards to go up as my coffin goes in to get cremated.
I want everyone in the best outfits. I want it to be glam as fuck, me.
Do you?
Yeah. Everyone best be dressed to the nines.
Have you got a funeral song?
I'll let you guys pick it.
You wouldn't want us to pick that.
I mean, I won't be able to stop you.
Toto Africa on.
No, it'd be Gigi Allen. I wanna fuck you in this. Take this shit out of your bag.
That does kind of fit my aesthetic of life, so yeah. Go for it.
I don't know. I don't know what my funeral song would be, but someone asked me not long ago, and it was like a really good question. I was made up with it. They were like, if you knew you were going to die tomorrow, what's the last movie you'd watch? And I was like, ooh.
So that's a question only for you.
Ooh, yeah. Great. No, it's a question for anyone. I just
is it? For you especially.
What would you go? Oh, that's your question. No.
No, I'll just go for a pint.
No, but the whole question is, you've got one last film to watch. What's the last film you're gonna watch before you? And don't make it like Showgirls or something like that.
I don't know. I don't really have.
Really, if you knew you were gonna. You were never going to watch a film again. You thought, I'm going to pick this film. This is my last movie I'm ever going to watch. I never give it much thought.
It's just really hard to.
Not even like Babe, Pig in the City, Babe 2.
There's nothing that comes to my mind. Like Toy Story or something.
I picked.
Love Toy Story.
And again, this is not funny at all, just really earnest and gay and cringy. I picked Monty Python in the. Life of Brian.
Life of Brian's class.
Just because of the end. Just because of the song at the end. Always looking the bright side of life. If I knew I was going to die and heard, and I'd like, I was fucked up and heard that song, I'd honestly think I'd be like, okay, yeah, sweet. Yeah.
Bring it on.
I'm going, yeah. I think it'd like ease me.
In your sleep, is it? You're dying in your sleep?
No, I don't.
Or as soon as the movie ends.
The movie ends, I come in and get stabbed to death. Pick the longest movie possible.
I was in the I go back to when I was in Munich, in the strip club in Munich. Do you like, you get to choose your song you want for the lap dance? Oh. So I was literally going to ask for like an episode of Good Time, just like a full on hour, just listening to us talking as I'm getting a lap dance.
Just my laugh in the background.
Did you get a lap dance?
Nah, it's like 120 euro.
Well, when the cameras go off, we'll ask you again.
Did you get a lap dance?
No, on a God's Honest Truth. I don't like strippers. I don't know.
You like prostitutes, just not strippers.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, I'm going all the way, or what's the point?
No. I hate the fucking energy in there. Like, it's stuck up girls. Like, there was one girl I had to dance in front of herself in the mirror, and she wouldn't look at anyone else. And then it's just all fellas there who've got money and that, and just like, there was an old guy there who had two strippers next to him. Nice. And he was just getting like rolling champagne on sparklers.
Listen, if you can do it, why not?
Yeah, I know, bro. I was just
yeah, didn't really care.
Why are you slagging off your granddad? Literally his life.
I thought you were dead. He's been immune. He's been immune for the last 20 years.
You had your fucking your pension letter come in though. I think we're getting at that age now where we need to start thinking about what we're doing.
So funny, man. I literally, you know, when you're about to walk out the door and you see your letter and you think, oh, I'll just open it and say quick before I go out. I just see him pension and just toss him out. Won't need that. As a comedian, mate, you're not going to need a fucking pension.
Pension
as a comedian is suicide.
Yeah.
It's fucking exactly pathetic, what it is.
It's either you make it or you don't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to Robin Williams myself out of this. Robin Williams?
Oh, if you said Robbie.
Oh, I can't.
Robbie Williams.
I want to keep the bins on, man, but it just hate me.
Your little Toms.
Where's your
bare ones? Proper eye adjustment, taking them off.
I've got my actual sunglasses on like a fucking twat.
Nice. Nice shape, then.
Ali, thank you. Yeah. I find it hard to find sunglasses to fit me head shape. I've got a bit of a...
I like your head shape.
I've got a head shape like a cooler.
A cooler,
you know, like something that like cool beers and shit like that. I don't know, it's got a mad shaped head, man. I haven't, because I used to have a skinhead when I was a kid all the time.
I was just about to ask you that. What was your I feel like you've got the shape for a skinhead though.
I don't think so.
Like the back of it.
I don't think so. I've got too much face for a skinhead.
Too much face.
My face is too big.
Oh my god! Can we tell Liv about your lump?
Oh yeah.
Where's so, the progress?
You know when we thought Keegan was gonna die because he had a lump on his face. We thought it was cancer.
See this little bugger here.
Yeah.
It started years ago as well. It started really small, and I was always like, ah, it's probably not. And I got to the point where people were like, just go and see.
Yeah. I was worried to be fair. Cause it was getting bigger.
And I saw a woman. I saw the GP and she was like, oh, she probably scared the life out of me. She was like, it may be. She went because it's unusual to have a growth in the face. She went it actually could be cancerous. Yeah. And I was like, what the fuck? And then put it off for ages, didn't get, and I had to go again. And this woman, who seemed well more competent, went, I think it's just a fat ball.
a fat deposit.
Yeah, what about my face?
She's like, yeah, I think it's just a ball of fat in your face.
She's looking at you, I think you're a fat ball. No, I'm here for this.
She never actually. She was.
Yeah.
She fancied me.
But being fat ball's so funny though.
Yeah. She went, I think it's if she didn't say fat ball. I used the word fat ball.
Yeah. So well, how does it get fat though?
I don't know, man. That's fucking.
Like, because people usually get weight on the bum.
Yeah, what? My dad's got them on his back.
What? Fat balls.
Yeah. They're called fatty deposits.
More than one.
What, like a camel?
Like a fucking like a Staffordshire Bull Terrier that should be put down. When you see Staffy's mates in the park, oh, yeah, like, and they're just dripping with humours. Yeah, like, yeah.
They're like speedballs.
No, boxing. Lad, there's not worse. Guys, I love dogs, but man, there's nothing seen worse than a staff, and it's always staffs for some reason. Who just got tubers hanging off the man? You're like, kill it, man. Just kill your dog.
Skinheads!
Just put a shovel. I can't afford. Just put a shovel over its head, mate.
It's like, oh, how cute he is. And it's looks blind, like it's walking at the table.
Looks like it's got dreadlocks.
Yeah. old dogs, man. They do need putting down.
Yeah.
Our little Harry's getting on though.
I don't think I'd have another dog.
He was out of breath sitting down before.
Mate, he's so scary, that dog, you know, because he's like, he's just like a big. He's just big. He's like me cheek. He's like a big fat boy. And he'll just run through you. He could just run through you if he wanted to.
Yeah, he's a massive tank.
He could overpower you easily.
Yeah, he is a big boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's the fucking. He's class though.
Yeah. Going for your dad's toolbox.
Yeah, and come up with tape. He just terrorizes me dad. Because me dad can't walk faster than that. Harry just proper has him off now.
That's so funny.
Do you reckon you'll get like a pet in that when you get your own place and stuff?
No.
Nope.
Why not?
I can barely fucking look after myself.
Oh, yeah.
That's true. I reckon you'd be one of them guys though that takes the dog to the pub.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
what I mean.
That's where I'm going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You'll definitely have a tumour dog, you.
Yeah. Little tumour dog.
The way that people always say that their owners look alike.
Yeah. Just the dog's grey with a fat face.
What the fuck?
We're having fun.
Sorry. Pretty beach!
No!
Can't wait for your next birthday, lad. What's next year, mate?
Yours is next month, though. You're getting the you for yours, mate. I'm on a baseball bat flower.
I forgot I'm away for all that.
Dead busy, sorry.
I can't wait. Next year, Callum. The Beardy Beats are going to be fucking...
I'm going to get a baseball
bat. I'm just going to punch him in his face. I'm just going to hit him in his face twice and be like, that counts as 30 punches. I'm going to hit you properly twice in the face.
I'd say, I'll let you know. Should we do a shout out for our sponsor, by the way?
Lenny Nooses?
Lenny Nooses. He's covered this episode again because it's a birthday one.
Oh, yeah.
So if anyone's out there looking for a noose... www.lennynooses.co.uk 50% off your second noose if it doesn't work.
Promo code good time. Yeah. Come on, let's listen to some Amy Winehouse before we go.
Should we karaoke out?
Yeah,
go on.
Karaoke out. For a Bertie.
Come on.
Wait there, hang on. What's your next karaoke song? Can we do it Forever in Blue Jeans?
Yeah. Liv, you're joining as well, by the way.
Oh my fuck.
Neil Diamond, everybody.
Feel the way that I'm singing along.
Oh, what a song, man.
Is there a move?
Yeah.
Oh, do you want it
higher?
Yeah, of course.
I always sing this in karaoke because now and again there'll be like a little old woman and you sing it to her.
I love it. With a half pint.
Yeah.
But it sucks. But it don't sing and dance and it don't walk. As long as I can have you here with me, I'd much rather be forever in blue jeans.
Oh, yes.
And heart is sweet. But it ain't nothing next to baby's treats. And if you pardon me, I'd like to say we'll do okay forever in blue jeans.
Here we go, this is the part you sing for the old woman.
Maybe tonight. Maybe tonight by the fire all alone by you the fire.
So dyslexic.
Nothing around but the sound of my heart and your sighs.
Here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4. But it talks. But it can sing and dance and it can walk. Long as I can have you here with me, I'd rather be forever in blue jeans, babe. And honey, sweet, honey, it ain't nothing next to baby's treats.
So easy to sing this.
And if you pardon me, I'd like to say, we'll do okay forever in blue jeans. Maybe tonight. Maybe tonight you and I all alone by the fire.
To the way around, definitely. To the way around, 100%.
Nothing around but the sound of your heart and your sighs.
1, 2, 3, 4.
But it sucks. But it don't sing and dance and it don't walk. All the longest time you here with me, I'd rather be forever in blue jeans. And if you pardon me, I'd like to say we'll do okay forever in blue jeans, babe. Have you here with me? I'd much rather be forever in blue jeans, babe.
Happy birthday, Callum.
Happy birthday. Woo!